ये वी आर इंटीग्रेटिंग दिस इंटीग्रल माइनस वन टू थ्री बाय टू मॉड ऑफ एक्स साइन पाई एक्स डी एक्स. दिस क्वेश्चन इज फ्रॉम योर क्लास एंड फ्रॉम योर बुक एनसीईआरटी. एज वी नो दैट मॉड ऑफ एक्स इज वॉट प्लस एक्स when x is greater or equal to 0, minus x when x is less than 0. What is x is equal to 0? X is equal to 0 is its critical value, because when x is greater than 0, its value is plus x, and when x is less than 0, its value is minus x. It is called its critical value. So first of all, we need to find critical value of the function mod of this x sin pi x. So to find its critical value, we shall have to equate this x sin pi x with 0. So on equating x sin pi x with 0, we find x is equal to 0, one critical value, or sin pi x is equal to 0. But it is not a critical value. It just indicates that critical value or values can be obtained by equating sin pi x with 0. So on equating sin pi x with 0, this implies pi x is equal to n pi, where n is what? Where n belongs to z. Z is what? So z is set of integers and its value is known to you: 0 plus minus 1 plus minus 2 up to infinity. And how do we come to know that this is pi x is equal to n pi? By using sine theta is equal to 0 gives us theta is equal to n pi, which is called general solution. Sin theta equal to 0 implies theta is equal to n pi, where n belongs to z. It is known to all of us. So this implies sin pi x is equal to 0 implies pi x is equal to n pi. Now you can see that pi can be cancelled, and this implies x is equal to n. And n is what? n belongs to this set. Therefore x is equal to 0 plus minus 1 plus minus 2 plus minus 3 and so on. But we are given that we need to integrate the given integral from x is equal to this value to x is equal to this value, means from x is equal to minus 1 to x is equal to 3 by 2. So we are given minus 1 should be less than or equal to x, less than or equal to 3 by 2. So only those values we shall consider from these values which are lying in this particular interval. So let's see which values are those which are lying in this interval. The first value is 0, no doubt. 0 is here and 0 is here, means 0 we have in two situations, so we cannot bifurcate in 0, means we cannot differentiate which 0 is this. 0 is 0. So x is equal to 0 is 1. Second is x is equal to minus 1. Third is x is equal to plus 1. Means this case minus 1 plus 1. And 3 by 2, what is 3 by 2? So 3 by 2 we know is 3 by 2 is 1.5. So only these values, not this plus 2, minus 2 or plus 3, minus 3, these will not be included. Only these values, 0, minus 1 and minus plus 1, these values must be considered. So the given integral is what? Minus 1 to 3 by 2. So we shall break this integral. Suppose this is minus 1 and this is 3 by 2. The values which are lying in this interval are 0, plus 1, minus 1 is here, and 3 by 2 we are given in the integral. So the integral we shall split into three parts: part 1, part 2, part 3. Means from minus 1 to 0, second from 0 to 1, and the third part will be from 1 to 3 by 2. So now it is clear that the given integral, which is from minus 1 to 3 by 2, mod of x sine pi x dx, we shall split into three integrals. The first will be minus 1 to 0, second will be from 0 to 1, and third is, of course, dx would be there, and dx and function x sine pi x. And the third part will be from 1 to 3 by 2. 1 to 3 by 2 x sine pi x dx. This third part is x sine pi x dx. X sine pi x dx. Now the problem is about signature. What sign, what signature should be used here? Minus or plus? Which will make it positive? Because now we have removed this absolute sign from the function. So the outcome must be positive. And how shall we come to know that outcome is positive? So to know that the outcome is positive, let's take any value from this interval, means from minus 1 to 0. Let's take any value from this interval. Let's say that the value is minus 1 by 2. So minus 1 by 2. And this minus 1 by 2 is lying somewhere here. We shall substitute this minus 1 by 2 in our function. F of x is equal to mod of x sine pi x. But when we shall substitute this value minus 1 by 2 into the function, we shall remove this absolute sign's signature. So we shall substitute in just this function. Let's put x is equal to minus 1 by 2 here. On putting minus 1 by 2, it becomes minus 1 by 2 sine of pi into minus 1 by 2. Minus can come outside the sign. So this minus and this minus will cancel each other. These two minus will cancel each other. 1 by 2 is 1 by 2, a positive value, and this will become sine pi by 2. Sine pi by 2 is 1. So 1 by 2 into 1 is a positive value. So therefore, in this particular interval, this function f of x is equal to mod of x sine pi x is already positive, means not mod, but the inner side is positive. So no need to put any kind of signature over here. Otherwise, suppose if it could be a negative value, in this particular interval, then we need to impose a negative sign, a more negative sign, because that negative value and this negative will make a positive value. So now let's put any value from this 0 to 1 into the function, and the function is same, f of x is equal to x sine pi x. We are not using modulus sign, not putting that absolute sign signature. Let's put any value from 0 to 1 by 1. Suppose value is 1 by 2. Don't think the length of interval, about the length of interval, that here length is unit, but it is, this point is looking closer and this point 1 is looking far. Don't worry about that. It is just for the experience. It is not actual length. So let's put x is equal to 1 by 2 into this. So on putting, it is 1 by 2 here, 1 by 2 into sine pi into 1 by 2. Sine pi by 2 is 1, 1 by 2 is 1. So 1 by 2 into 1, a positive value. So here we shall put a positive. No need to put a plus sign, but for the sake of confidence, I am putting here positive sign. And don't think that alternately plus minus plus will appear. You have seen here that in the first case, plus sign is there. In the second integral, again plus sign is there. Let's put x is equal to any value greater than 1 and less than 3 by 2. So any value greater than 1 and less than 3 by 2. 3 by 2 is what? It is 1.5. So let's put any value lying between this interval, 1.25. 1.25 or 5 by 4. So on putting 5 by 4 here, instead of x in this function, it becomes 5 by 4 sine 5 pi by 4. Sine 5 pi by 4. So if you know the graph of sine function or quadrant system, sine 5 pi by 4 will lie somewhere in third quadrant, because it is more than pi. It is 1.25 pi or 225 degree, you can say. So 225 degree is lying in third quadrant, and we know that in third quadrant sine is negative. This 5 by 4 is positive, but sine 5 pi by 4 is a negative value. So the outcome will be what? A negative value. But as this value x sine pi x was lying in a modulus function which cannot be negative, so to make it a positive value, we shall just impose a negative sign here so that the outcome will be positive. To make the outcome a positive value, because if we do not put any negative sign, you may think, or it may seems to you, that this is a positive value, but actually it is not a positive value, because in this interval from 1 to 3 by 2, it is a negative value, as we have seen, we have experienced. So as per the critical values, this integral is divided into three parts, and we have put signatures before the function as per our need. Now you can see that in the first part and in the second part, functions are same, both are positive, so we can club them. Minus 1 to 1 x sine pi x sine pi x dx. In the third part, minus can be taken common or minus can come outside. 1 to 3 by 2 x sine pi x. In both, integrands are same, but limits are different. So let's calculate this integral x sine pi x, and then we'll substitute in both the integrations. So now we are trying to integrate this x sine pi x using integration by parts. Let's say this x is first function, sine pi x is second function. Using Eilert rule, inverse should be first, but no inverse is there. Log should be first, but no log is there. Algebraic should be first, and a is x is algebraic, so algebraic is first. And then trigonometric should be given priority later. So sine pi x being trigonometric function is second function. Now let's integrate using the rule. First function constant. Integration of second function dx. While integrating this integral, no need to put limits. Just integrate it, but mind it that no integral constant should be used. Ddx of first function, integration of second, and then dx again. We have used integration by part formula, which says integration of two functions, first into second, should be integrated like this. First constant, integration of second, minus differentiation of first function, integration of second, again dx for this bigger integral. And the second thing, integration of sine of ax plus b is minus cos ax plus b upon coefficient of x, and similarly integration of cos of ax plus b is sin ax plus b upon coefficient of x, which is a. So these results must be used now in integrating this x. Integration of sin pi x can be integrated through this formula, minus cos pi x upon coefficient of x, which is pi, minus differential of first is 1. Yeah. Integral of sine pi x is minus cos pi x upon coefficient of x, which is pi dx. This minus and this minus will cancel each other. Now at the last, we can write minus 1 upon pi x cos pi x plus 1 upon pi common. Now to integrate this cos pi x, we shall use this integral's formula. Integration of cos ax plus b is sin ax plus b upon a. So it becomes sin pi x upon pi. So at the last, we have come to this conclusion that integral of this function means integral of x sin pi x is minus x cos pi x upon pi plus sin pi x upon sin pi x upon pi square. No integral constant should be used. So directly we shall put integration of x sin pi x is equal to this. Instead of integrating it twice, because two integrations are there, so the integral i is equal to the first limit is minus 1 to 1, x is equal to minus 1, 2x is equal to plus 1, and the integral is minus x cos pi x upon pi plus sin pi x upon pi square minus integral of second function, same integration, same value, this value minus x cos pi x upon pi plus sin pi x upon pi square, and x is from 1 to 3 by 2. So wherever we wish to write, we can write here or here, no issue, no problem. So I can write here x is equal to 1 to x is equal to 3 by 2. It does not matter where we are writing. First of all, we shall put upper limit to calculate its value, and then we'll subtract value of the function from the function after putting upper limit. Minus 1, we are putting upper limit x is equal to 1 here, minus 1 into cos of pi into minus 1. So cos of pi into minus 1, you know, is minus pi whole upon pi. Now we shall put x, sorry, we need to put x is equal to 1. I am extremely sorry. It should be cos pi. And we are putting x is equal to 1 in this. So it is sin pi into 1, sin pi upon pi square. We have substituted x is equal to 1 means upper limit in the function. Now we shall subtract the function after putting lower limit. Minus is already there and x is minus 1. So it is minus minus 1 cos of pi into minus 1 means cos of minus pi. So I can write directly cos of minus pi whole upon pi plus sin of pi into minus 1 is sin minus pi upon pi square, bracket close. So this is the value of the first part. Now second part is already having a negative sign, so minus is there. Let's put a bracket. Now we shall put x is equal to 3 by 2 instead of x, minus 3 by 2 cos 3 pi by 2 upon pi plus sin 3 pi by 2 upon pi square minus, now we shall put x is equal to 1, lower limit, minus 1 into cos pi upon pi plus sin pi upon pi square. Just close the bracket. Now, cos pi is what? Cos pi is cos 180 degree, and cos 180 degree is minus 1. Sin pi means sin 180 degree is 0. Cos 3 pi by 2, cos 270 degree, cos 270 degree is 0. Sin 3 pi by 2, sin 270 degree is minus 1. You can find values of these functions using graph. For example, graph of sine is like this. So sine of 3 pi by 2 will be lying here, 3 pi by 2, 270 degree, and its value is minus 1. Sine pi is this value, sine pi is 0. And similarly for cos, you can use this graph. Cos pi is here. This is 90 degree, this is 180 degree cos pi, and this value is minus 1. Here you can see it is minus 1. And cos 3 pi by 2, this is what, pi by 2, add one more pi, then it becomes 3 pi by 2, and cos 3 pi by 2 is 0. So now we shall substitute these values here to evaluate our integral. First part, minus 1 into cos pi being minus 1 will make it plus 1. Pi, sin pi you see is 0. Minus, this minus into minus plus. So it is 1. Cos of minus theta is known to you. Cos of minus theta is cos theta. So cos of minus pi will be same as cos pi, which is minus 1. Minus 1 upon pi plus sin minus theta is minus sin theta. But minus sin pi will be 0. Therefore, sin of pi is 0 and sin of minus pi both are 0. So it is 0. Now, second part, minus 3 by 2, cos 3 pi by 2, you can see, cos 3 pi by 2 is what? It is 0. So this part is 0. Plus sin 3 pi by 2 is what? Minus 1. So it is minus 1 upon pi square. Minus this last calculation, minus 1 into cos pi. Cos pi is minus 1, therefore it is plus 1 upon pi. And sin pi is being 0, it is 0. So at the last, 1 upon pi, this minus into minus will cancel each other. 1 upon pi plus minus this minus will make plus 3 by 2 pi, x is 3 by 2. Okay. Minus into this minus, sorry, it is 0. 3 by 2 pi into 0, so it is 0. This minus into minus will become plus 1 upon pi square, minus 1 by pi. Minus 1 by pi. But this bracket is having negative sign here. So this minus and this minus will cancel each other. So it becomes 1 upon pi. So finally, its integral is 1 upon pi, 1 upon pi, thrice, 3 upon pi, plus 1 upon pi square. If you wish to take LCM, you may. So LCM is pi square, and the outcome is this 3 pi plus 1 pi square. Finally, this is the answer of the given integral. Hope you enjoyed it.